to our internet guests. Again, if you haven't already, please go down and subscribe to this cast so that when we come up, you'll be notified. That way you won't miss us. And also, we encourage you to share with your family, your friends, your Sunday school classes that we're here, so they too can join in and be blessed by the Word of God here at World Class Sunday School. Somebody tell me what's wrong with the people today. Somebody tell me what's wrong with the people today. Seems like the brother of love faded away. We welcome you to World Class Sunday School. As always, it's a pleasure to have you join us as we continue to read and study God's Word. Let us go in prayer. Lord, again, we are grateful and thankful for this opportunity to sit at your feet, to glean from your words. We just give you praise and glory and honor because of your love and care for us. It's in Jesus' name we pray and give you thanks and praise as always. Amen. Well, friends, I'm just excited about what's before us today. We're continuing. Well, actually, this is the last lesson in Unit 2 in our fall quarter, celebrating God and called to praise God. Here today, we're going to praise God for His greatness. Our lesson is coming from Psalms verses 1 through 5 and Psalms 149 and then the entire 150th Psalm. And today, in Psalms 149, Israel could say hallelujah because God had delivered them from their enemies. And we can say hallelujah because the kingdom has come through redemption by the blood of Jesus Christ and judgment by His powers. And also in Psalms 150, the grand finale of praises, and we're going to see God being praised with music, with songs, with dance, and everything that has breath is going to verbally praise Him. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. These two outlines, we're going to follow a new song, Psalms 149, verses 1 through 5, and then the second outline, the setting of praise, Psalms 150. So let's just jump right in here and see what the Lord has in store for us on today. The first outline's a new song, verses 1 through 5. Praise ye the Lord, sing unto the Lord a new song, and His praises in the congregation of saints. Let Israel rejoice in Him that made Him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise His name in the dance. Let them sing praises unto Him with the timbrels and harp. Let the Lord take His pleasure in His people. He will beautify the meek with salvation. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds. And we're going to look at this first outline, a new song, and beginning here in verse 1, it talks about a call to praise. And actually, in reading the Psalms, back in Psalms 146, it begins and goes through 150, where we are called to praise God. It says, praise ye the Lord. We know that hallelujah is the highest praise. It actually, it's a universal language, the word hallelujah. And hallelujah is a command to praise. And luyah, jah is meaning Yahweh. And so we are called to praise Yahweh, who is the God of Israel, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And then it calls here in verse 1, sing unto the Lord a new song. Israel circumstances had changed. They had been returned to their land from captivity, and so this called for newness. And we too have our circumstances have been changed when we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And we give God credit for what he's doing in our lives. And that's why we can sing a brand new song. And then it goes on to talk about, still in verse 1, and it says, and his praise in the congregation of saints. And actually, what we're looking at here is, and what we look at verses 1 through 4, he's calling for a public, a corporate praise and worship. And his praise in the congregation of the saints. That's the church house. That's what he's talking about here. Those who did not forget to assemble themselves together as God has commanded us to do. That's how we come together. We are called to come together and praise God as a collective body of believers. Now, make no mistake about it. There are some who believe that going to church is not a requirement, but we see the principle of God's word teach us that God has commanded us to assemble ourselves together. And then it says, let Israel rejoice in him that made him. He's talking about the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The creator, God made us. He made Israel. He made us in his image. And we can rejoice because of that. Because we even exist, we can rejoice in God. Because he is our creator. And it said, let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Now, this verse, we've talked about a parallelogram down through our lessons. And this is a example of that here in verse 2. And it says, a parallelogram, we said that it's a statement, a double statement, where one part of the statement reinforces the other part. And here when it says, let Israel, he's talking about let the children, and he said, let the children of Zion. And it says, let them rejoice, and reinforce and rejoice is be joyful. And then it says, in him that made him, in their king, the creator, God Almighty, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the creator of heaven and earth. And we know that God spoke into existence everything that is. And this is a designating of signifying who is to be praised, and that's God Almighty. In verse 3 it says, let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises unto him with the temple and harp. And here in verse 3, we see the instruments of praise. Here the psalmist provides means for expressing praise and joy, dancing to the sound of music, musical instruments. And then we see the command to praise, and we see the command for public praise here in verses that in these verses that we're looking at now. And here in praise God, it says praise God, the praising God in public, the congregation of saints, that's the church, and celebrating with song, music, and dance. So we are to praise God. We're to praise him in the sanctuary, or we're to come together collectively to praise God. And that's what we see here through verses 1 through 3. And then verse 4, it says a reason for praise. Okay? We've seen the praise, the place for praise, and how we to praise. We are to come together collectively and praise, and public praise. And now the reason for praise, it says, for the Lord taketh pleasure in his people. And what we're looking at here really is we are designed by God to praise him. God gets glory and joy out of our praise. And so let us praise him because it pleases God. It pleases God when we praise him. And we want to be pleasing to God. And when we praise him with our whole hearts, when we praise him in spirit and in truth, God is pleased with that. And so we want to be found pleasing God. And we can please him by praising him. He will beautify the meek with salvation. Here in this last portion of this verse. And so the reason for praising God is we should praise God because he gets pleasure out of our service. God gets pleasure out of our prosperity. And God, he gets pleasure out of our communion with him. And so if God is getting pleasure out of these things that we do, like our service and our prosperity and our communion with him, then why shouldn't we have a really keen desire to praise him? Because we know that this is pleasing in his sight. Now, be mindful now, we have to praise him in spirit and in truth. Now, if our praise is not in spirit and in truth, then it's going to be like God is going to reject it. But if we praise him with our whole hearts in spirit and in truth, God is going to take pleasure in that. And that's what we want to, we just want to please God. We want to be pleasing in his sight. You know, we can praise God with melodious sounding music from the singing and the instruments. But if we're not doing it wholeheartedly, if we're not doing it because of our love for him and what he's done for us, then it's going to be like sounding brass. But even if we praise him and out of tune, God is going to get pleasure out of it when we do it wholeheartedly. And so he wants our praise, and we should be enthusiastic about praising God because God has done so much for us. So much for us. And when I look back over my life, I just want to say hallelujah, praise God from where he's brought me from. And I know you had the same testimony. And so there shouldn't be any hesitant in our praise to God. We should, as the scripture tells us, we should enter into his gates with thanksgiving and to his courts with praise and be thankful to him because God has done all for us. And when you think about it, where would we be if God was not on our side? And that's enough right there to just stop and give God all the praises and all the glory that we can muster up. And I just thank him. And I don't mind praising God in public. I don't mind saying hallelujah. I don't mind lifting up my hands and lifting up my voice praising God because God, we serve a mighty God. And when we think about how good God is to us, man, we shouldn't hesitate to praise him. And that's the least of our service, is to give God praise and glory and honor for what he's done in our lives. And I'm just moved by this portion of our lesson that's calling for us to praise God. I'm moved by it. And I just want to praise him, and I want God to know that I love him, and I don't mind praising him. Okay, so this is our call to praise is a command by God to come together in unison and give him praise and glory. And that's the public praise. Okay, and now in verse 5, that was verses 1 through 4, it talks about giving him that type of praise, and then it gives a reason why we should praise him. And here in verse 5 in our call to praise, we see another call to praise. Verses 1 through 4 was the public call to public praise. Here in verse 5, it's a private call to praise. It says, "Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds." Now, when we are at home, we are called to praise God in our private time. Not just when we are at church or in public, but when we think about what God has done in our lives, even if we're just sitting around the house, when we can muster up a praise, and we should muster up a praise, because if you can't praise God in private, then if you can't praise God in private, then your public praise is not going to mean that much. It's hypocritical, really. Because if you can only praise God in public and can't praise him in private, it's a hypocritical praise. But the scripture tells us in Psalms 119 and 62. Now, we know that David was a praiser. He was a man after God's own heart, but he always gave God the praise and glory for what God had done in his life. And that scripture in Psalms 119 and 62 tells us that David rose out of his bed to give God praise. And so I'm saying again, without private praise and worship, we are but hypocrites in our public praise and worship. And so we should be willing to give God praise at all times, even when we are in our private time. And so here in this first outline, where we talk about a new song, and we know that Israel had a new song because God had changed their circumstances. They had been in captivity in Babylon for 70 years, and he had brought them out and delivered them from their enemies. And for us, God has made perfect his plan of salvation for us. And we know that through the blood of Jesus Christ, we have been brought out of our circumstances and given a new life. And so because of that, we should have a new song on our hearts and a praise on our lips for God who had made all this possible. And then we're going to turn our attention to the second portion of our lesson. And here, Psalms 150, just a beautiful song, just a beautiful finish to the whole book of Psalms. Psalms 150. And here in this psalm, we're going to talk about the setting for praise. Okay, in the first outline, we talked about a new song. And here we're going to talk about the setting of praise. And I just want to read Psalms 150 again. That's a beautiful psalm. It says, "Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbre and dance. Praise him with the string instruments and organ. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And here in this the setting of praise, in the first verse, it tells us where to praise. It says, praise ye the Lord, praise God in the sanctuary. Again, we're talking about the location where God's people gather, the church house. And look, this is not a request, a command from God, and we are required to come together and praise God in the church house. And then it goes on to say, verse 1 goes on to say, praise him in the firmament of his power. And praising God for his power, look, we can just see when we look at creation and see God's power in what has been created. The sun and that gives light to the day, the moon that gives light to the night, the stars in the sky, billions of stars, and God knows each one by name. That kind of power, we can praise God for that when we see and realize how God has created everything. And then it says, that was the first portion. Verse 1 was where to praise him. And then verse 2 talks about why we praise him. It says, praise him for his mighty acts. Praise God for his mighty acts. And see, Israel was when they thought about how God had kept them through a captivity and had brought them out. And when we think about how God is keeping us, then we can praise him for his mighty acts. And then it says, praise him according to his excellent greatness. Thank God for being the great God he is. And when we look back over our past and see what God has, by his power, has brought us to where we are now, then we shouldn't have any problem praising him for what he's done in our lives. And then because of his excellent greatness, God is a great God. He's omnipotent. That's all powerful. He's all omnipresent. He's always with us, and he's promised that he would never leave us or forsake us. And he's omnipotent. He knows all. And that's how awesome he is. That's how great he is. And we can thank him for his excellent greatness. And then it talks about where, why, and how. And how here it says, praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harps. And these are musical instruments that's used in praise and worship. And praise him with the timbrel and dance. And then it says, praise him with the string instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. And we talk all these instruments. We're talking about praising God with music and song. And we stated earlier now, remember now, when we praise God, regardless of what we use to aid us in our praise and worship, we must do it sincerely. We must do it sincerely. out of the love in our hearts for God. And when we do that, when we praise Him wholeheartedly and sincerely, it's like a sweet savor in God's nostril. And in all this come together, the music instruments and the singing and the dancing, all this come together in sincerity, and God is pleased with it. God adores that. God longs for that from us. And that's we owe God that. We owe God praises because of who He is and what He's done in our life. We owe Him praise and worship. But if we're not doing it sincerely, then again, all these musical instruments is gonna in our singing and our dancing is gonna be like noise to Him. But we want to make a joyful noise. We want God to be pleased with our celebration and praising Him with musical instruments, with dancing, and with singing. And then the sixth verse, we talked about where, why, how, and now who. It says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. We're talking about God Almighty, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, our Lord and Savior who brought us out of darkness into the marvelous light. It says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Do you have breath in your body today? Then use it to give God praise and glory. Why? Because He so richly deserves it. Lord, we thank You for this time. Again, we are grateful that You allow us to read and study Your word, to glean Your truth. We love You, Lord, because of what You've done for us. We worship You because of who You are, God Almighty. And we give You praise and honor on today. It's in Jesus' name we pray and give You thanks and praises always. Well, again, friends, hallelujah. Praise God. We thank You for joining us on today. And we look forward to having You in our next session. So until then, may God richly bless and keep you is our prayer. Somebody.